Headspace's mission is to improve the health and happiness of the world. It actually started as meditation-focused events in London. Attendees, they were coming up asking for more and seeing if there was something they could bring home with them that they could use for their personal meditation practice.
And so that's exactly what Headspace did. They became the global leader of meditation and mindfulness, really, in the app space. Not everyone is going to start a daily meditation practice, so we wanted to think of new and innovative ways that we could still bring our users mindfulness content without have it being solely focused on only meditation.
And if you were to open an app today, we also now have tools to help you get a better night's sleep, to help you focus and get up and move. It's really a holistic approach to health and happiness. Going beyond meditation meant going beyond what we had in the app to date. And one of the ways that we did this was by expanding the information architecture of the experience and really going under the hood on our primary navigation. User experience and quality of the app is immensely important to us here at Headspace. We know that members come to us in moments of stress and anxiety, and we don't want to cause more stress or anxiety opening Headspace. One of the ways that we went about doing this was actually consulting best practices, looking at things like typography, color systems, iconography, especially navigation patterns, to really ensure that the solution that we ended on was frictionless for members and very clear how they could use Headspace in their day-to-day. The availability of Google's design resources, the material design tools, made it a lot more simple and a lot more approachable.
Our major area of focus was building this really, really solid foundation. And we didn't have years and years to build this experience. We had about 8 months. And so we took this crazy leap of faith and went to our engineering leaders and asked if we could just rebuild the whole thing from scratch. We knew that we wanted something that was going to scale. And that was a big factor of why we chose to go with 100% Kotlin from the start. It's safer, it's more succinct, you know, there's less boilerplate code.
Something that was really complex in terms of design was color. And the Google tools really simplified that approach for us and helped us create a framework to look at how we're using color, how it's going to help us do a global dark mode, and how it keeps our product accessible for all.
It was much more than an engineering rebuild. We were working with the design team, we were working with the product team, we were working with the marketing team. Everyone played such a significant role and really made our Android app a huge, huge company priority. We did see an increase in our user engagement, also very substantial increase in our reviews. I really think it was a combination using all of the tools within the Google Play console and these new features that really drove the growth that we were hoping to see from it.
Our renewed investment in Android has totally paid off and is going to keep paying dividends for years to come.